presentation of the NBA.
It's Friday night, and live on 2K Sports. We're going to bring you the NBA and all its excitement. And David, great stuff, David. Thank you. Well, after the Raptors fell short of their goals last season, you knew they were going to be changing some things up.
Well, obviously, the first big move was moving on from Dwayne Casey as the head coach. And if you think about, Dwayne had brought the best years this franchise had seen, and they still felt it was time for a shift. Now, it's not necessarily his blame. Sometimes you just need to hear a new voice when you've ended in the playoffs the way they have over the last several years.
Now Sacramento starting five. They've got him on Shumpert. Ayelica is out there with Buddy Hield. And it's Fox. And it's Cauley Stein in at the five, roaming the paint. A shot by Lowry, no good. Here's Ayelica. Here's Shumpert. And it's blocked by Ibaka.
Boy, great extension from Ibaka. His length, always a factor.
Lowry, good. Now, here's Fox. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now, you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Kicks it out to Leonard. We play just over a minute here in the first. Back to Lowry. Fires the three. That's Lowry again missing. For Sacramento, they've gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Hield from outside. He's off on that one. And Toronto will go the other way with it.
Scoreless after four shots. Wow.
Leonard, no luck.
Boy, a wide open look from mid-range that goes by the wayside. You can tell he's upset.
Shumpert against Lowry. And too much time in the lane, they get called for the three-second violation. For Toronto, they've gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. And there's the three-second call, this one on the defense. The Raptors shooting their first free throw of the night here.
And last season, as a team, they knocked down 79% of their free throws, so those are numbers you'll be happy with.
And the free throw, no good, but they'll get the ball back here. No good on the quick three.
Well, he continues to have trouble with his shot, well below 50% from the field in this period.
Second chance shot, good on the bucket.
Defensive rebounding, just such a crucial part of the game.
I'll tell you, if you don't box out well, expect to get burned. You can't afford to give them second chance opportunities.
And so far this quarter, he's been a little off on his game.
Yeah, scoring isn't coming naturally to him right now. Looking a little bit uncomfortable out there.
Nemanja Bjelica, the 2015 EuroLeague MVP, a product of Belgrade, Serbia.
You know, not many people know he grew up in the rough housing complexes known as the blocks in his native country. Similar to New York City in that there's plenty of competition on the basketball courts in that area. And he believes that helped to prepare him for the NBA challenge.
Toronto's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. Outside Lowry. Pass to Leonard. Outside for Lowry. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Lowry's got 5 points so far.
What a fluid perimeter game. Kyle Lowry, a consistent threat from deep.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Pulls up on the wing, and that one's good. Leonard. Leonard's got his first basket.
Boy, this guy's a rock. You know, this is a player that you can count on to produce under any circumstance.
And out of bounds, it's the Raptors gain possession. Sacramento making some changes. Giles check in for Bjelica. Justin Jackson comes in for Hield, and it's Bogdanović in for Iman Shumpert. Pass to Green, and stolen by Bogdanović. outside Leonard. And the lead now, double digits on that bucket. 5 points in the game.
And off to a strong start offensively. He's got a nice touch.
But they'll get another chance. Shot to stop the run. And the rejection by Leonard.
And a sensational individual defender. Leonard will lock you down. Rejections are just part of the package he brings on the defensive end.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now. Jonas Valanciunas, he's checked in for Ibaka. OG Anunoby comes in for Pascal Siakam. Wright, he's checked in for Green. And it's Fred VanVleet in for Kyle Lowry. Here's Bogdanovich. It's rebounded by Anunoby.
I don't think the defense is much of a factor there. He just botches the finish.
Raptors leading by 10. VanVleet kicks to Leonard.
Just waiting for a chance to make a play, and when the pass was made, he's all over it. Just a fantastic steal.
And the officials call him for a 3-second violation. Toronto's gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from 3-point range so far in the first. To the inside. Sweet move, and finished off by Leonard.
I'll tell you, it takes fantastic vision and flawless timing to produce an assist like that.
So the Kings call timeout, their first. And Doris, to try and improve the flow of the games, teams now have fewer timeouts. Players have to be faster about retaking the court after stoppages. I'm assuming you're like me, all good things, right?
I agree, Kevin, and I think what people don't know is the impetus from this actually came from the coaches themselves. Rick Carlisle said, listen, we need to pick up the pace of play because we'd like our games to fit in a certain time frame. And listen, when you've got the leadership at the top in Adam Silver, who always makes clear that game flow is one of his focuses and that this is an entertainment medium and let's please our fans, you're going to make the right choices.
Exceptional play across the board. I love their tenacity. Just piling it on at this point.
You know, the beauty is it hasn't just been offense, right? It's been the defensive end as well. They're firing on all cylinders right now.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
For three, that ball is good for another field goal. His sixth, he is 6 for 9 on the stat sheet.
Well, he's kept them in balance tonight. This guy's shooting has put them in front.
Giles not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down.
And not everyone can shoot this well at his size.
No, there's no question about it. Guys with size don't necessarily translate into great shooters. But, boy, does he show great confidence knocking that down.
For Toronto, they have shot just one free throw, missing that one earlier. And the technical free throw is good.
Well, how about DeLon Wright having his best season as a pro last year? He had tremendous numbers, solidifying his role as a backup point guard. And I'll tell you this, he had some games where he simply took over.
Toronto leading by 21. Nobody near Leonard. No good on the three.
Oh, he'd like to have that one back. He almost never get that wide open a look.
Bogdanovich, no luck.
Still unable to connect this quarter. Really looks frustrated. Just needs to try and stay calm.
And you're just not going to see him do that very often. Usually when he rises up, there's a guarantee it's going down.
And they pick up two. Fox has got his first 2 points of the night.
And you have to have respect for his speed in transition. Fox is a high-octane player who explodes in the open floor.
CJ Miles.
There's 14 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Williams. And that one hits back iron. Fast break Toronto. Here's VanVleet. Here's Valanciunas. And as we conclude the first quarter, a one-sided game so far. Toronto ahead, up 19. And the second quarter will be... Making his mark in Toronto, guard Kyle Lowry talked about the pioneers of Canadian basketball, like Vince Carter.
Vince Carter really changed the game of basketball.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Carter's exciting style of play, GA, really energized the whole country.
And playing basketball in a hockey town isn't easy. But Carter really helped get this city and country energized about the game of basketball.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And a very convincing performance from the Raptors so far.
I mean, they're winning the turnover battle, and oftentimes that can swing things your way.
Well, you really like the activity on the defensive end. Outstanding jumping into passing lanes and coming up with steals.
Anunoby out there with Jonas Valanciunas. Then there's C.J. Miles, and it's Wright in at the two. That's the group for Toronto to start the second quarter. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Well, the Kings signed some quality vets last season, but when the losses piled up, they decided to go young. Now, the focus is on development. The veterans still have a role, providing steadying presence on the court and in the locker room. Kevin?
David, it certainly is a balancing act. Thanks for that report. Here's Anunoby. Passes it to Van Vliet. Clock at six. And it's a defensive three-second violation. Valanciunas doesn't play a ton of minutes, Doris, but fans feel he should be playing more.
Well, there's certainly a lot to like about Valanciunas' game. And how about last season? Because the NBA is changing, he can now step beyond the three-point arc and make those shots consistently. That will elevate his position and standing.
Catching up on the changes for Toronto. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Jonas Valanciunas. Pascal Siakam comes in for OG Anunoby. And Kyle Lowry subbed in for Fred VanVleet. The Raptors making a switch here. Green's checked in. Lowry kicks to Siakam. Down low, Ibaka, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
You know, and Serge Ibaka, a player who kind of came into the league as a defensive stopper, shot blocker. You know, still has great length and can bother shots, but not the prolific shot blocker he once was, as the focus has become more on the offensive end.
Well, let's remember, Serge Ibaka is a defensive presence. This guy, an elite shot blocker early in his career, and he is now a capable scorer from just about anywhere.
Timeout called by the Kings. And with Ibaka, at one point, would average almost four blocks a game.
Yeah, I mean, it is hard for any player to maintain a pace that high at this stage. Ibaka's done well to adjust, I think, his capabilities and make sure he can still have an impact on defense. The block numbers won't ever be as gaudy as they once were, but he is still causing problems for shooters.
And he comes up with the deuce.
That's a big payoff for crashing the offensive boards. Go to work.
The feed now to Miles. The shot's good on the assist by Lowry.
Well, for all the talk about the accurate shooters in the league, give it up to Kyle Lowry for his precise passing ability.
Shumpert, no good. Toronto's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Shumpert against Lowry. Ibaka right side. Outside, Green, and it's a defensive three-second violation. Out of offenses, Doris, initiate that high pick-and-roll offense, which is so fun to watch. Which ball handlers do you want running that play for you if you were on the sideline?
Come on now. There are some master manipulators in the pick-and-roll. Let's begin with the great James Harden. We'll begin with his teammate Chris Paul. Steph Curry. You give Steph Curry options to read in a pick-and-roll, he's going to make the right choice. There are a lot of guys who can manipulate the defense in a pick-and-roll, but those three are at the top of my list.
Shumpert passes to Bialica from deep three-point range, and the foul called on Pascal Siakam. That's his first foul. And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter.
Boy, that's all by design now. Get the shot as soon as possible on that inbound pass.
Lowry kicks to Green. And again, no good by Toronto. Shumpert finds heel. No good off the front iron.
Yeah, bad shot there. Trust is lacking. You got to be willing to make the extra pass.
I'm not sure why he doesn't continue to move the basketball. Would have served that team much better.
Williams passes to Cauley-Stein. Over Ibaka. The shot by Cauley-Stein. No good.
a little ambitious on that possession, trying to hit a shot in the face of that defensive pressure. Yeah, this looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowing.
And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, again, the miss by the Kings.
Well, he tries to answer with a three of his own and can't do it. You can't get caught up in the one-on-one aspect.
Lowry has the open look. And again, Toronto with the triple.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Here's Shumpert. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. The pass to Bialyts. Shot to stop the run. Misses off the right iron.
He's trying to make something happen, but obviously been a tough quarter.
Lowry for three, and again, Toronto with the triple.
12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks shell-shocked.
Williams, that's a two-pointer, and it's Toronto with the rebound.
They're really frustrating right now. They just can't seem to stem the tide here.
Nothing they're doing on the defensive end is working. They've got to figure something out, and fast.
And how about the last five made shots have all been threes? The defense is just giving up a barrage.
Moves back up, and that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
The Kings shooting their first shots of the night from the charity stripe. LeGreg and Willie Cauley-Stein, a live wire seven-footer.
I mean, he's got great foot speed for his size. I'd just like to see him really become more aggressive offensively and try to improve that skill set. But his mobility is so desirable in today's game. They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
Jackson, that's a two-pointer. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Alan Jones has got his fourth rebound in this one. DeLon Wright, he's checked in for Toronto. And it's Leonard with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. They've only allowed 5 points in the quarter. There's 53 seconds left to play in the first half. And it's out of bounds. And they say it was last touched by Leonard.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
51 seconds left here in the second. Here's Fox. Doesn't get it to drop for him. And Toronto will come the other way.
And another miss. Oof, he's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right. Here's Leonard. Back to Van Vliet. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist. Leonard's got his third assist on the night.
Keeping the pressure on and starting to pad this lead around the halfway point.
Yeah, seems like they're starting to pull away a bit right now. They just look a little faster and a little hungrier than the opposition right now.
And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. Raptors shooting and feeling it offensively in the second quarter. They're shooting 60%. Sacramento grabs the miss. Jackson's got four rebounds now tonight. And it's Giles missing. Leonard from deep, three-point land. And no good on the last second attempt this time. And so it's Toronto with a huge lead at the break. Safe to say there's no catching them today. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. And now we'll send it over to David.
Greetings, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson here with